Alright, we're going to be testing the new Parrot Anafi AI. Right now, I got it up in the air, first launch. Testing all the controls. Left and right, forward and back, up and down, making sure everything's working correctly. Now we're strictly on Wi-Fi, no 4G. It's just the controller and the drone. So far it is flying pretty nicely, and it's kind of windy today too. Oh, and also there's no geolock out here. Normally if you fly a DJI drone out here in this field, you have to unlock it. Here, no unlocking. Now what you see in the front is it's got obstacle avoidance sensors, and they move forward and back. That's what you see moving right there. When you go backwards, they flip backwards, and if you go forward, they flip forward. It's kind of weird. I guess it's because the cameras are not mounted on the drone. They move. Only thing is there's no obstacle avoidance going side to side. Only front and back, down and up. Alright, so now we're going to test its first range to see how far it can go. To the left of the screen there is what you see on the iPhone. And then the main screen is what you're seeing from the drone itself. So I'm flying to the field next to me. Now granted, there's no houses around here. There's not a lot of interference and stuff. So once you get in an environment of houses and a lot of telephone lines, telephone poles and stuff, the range may vary. We don't know yet. So as you can see, it's going out quite a ways and still getting a good signal. That's a down shot, straight down shot. Wanted to make sure where I was. Now we're just flying it back to us. In the lower left screen, you see a little green dot. That shows on the iPhone or iPad mini, whatever, on the screen. That green dot is your home. Let you know where home is. Now, if you look on the iPhone screen to the right, there's usually a map, but you have to hotspot it to a phone or some kind of cellular device in order to get or download a map. Right now I'm over here by a telephone pole, and I'm going to zoom in with the camera to see how detailed it gets without getting too close to the pole. It looks pretty good. Right there on the left, it's a 3.5 zoom right there. If you look on the iPhone screen there, now I'm up to maximum zoom 6. That's a maximum 6 zoom right there. Look how steady that is. At the end of the video, I took some pictures. I'll show the pictures at the very end of the video. Now, see, you can't see the map. So now we're gonna go a little bit further. We're gonna go across the street. See how far we can go. Thank you. making sure I'm above those power lines before I take off. And here we go. We're going to see how far it goes. Now if it does lose signal, it will automatically return to home. And it has an option there where it can return to pilot or home. So if you're moving in a vehicle, if you have it return to pilot, the drone will come to where the controller is, not where it took off. That's pretty far. Still got a good signal. It just decided not to go any further on its first flight. But hey, that's good enough for inspections. 4G, if you get it, the 4G SIM card put in the drone, you can obviously go as far as you want to go. Now I'm testing the return to home. Push the return to home button. And it's going to go to where that green dot is, which is where I'm standing. There it comes above me. Now it won't land automatically. What it'll do is it'll come down and hover about 10 feet and then you have to hit the land button on the controller to land it. Can't land it with the sticks and you can't take off with the sticks. You have to take off with the button and you have to land with the button. See, it's coming right on top of me because that's where I'm standing. So you can still move it manually so it doesn't land on top of you. That's what I'm doing now. And now I hit the land button.